Well, the longest table in Sarasota will be set up downtown on Lemon Avenue for a sophisticated street party. The annual banquet on the block is being organized by the 27th annual Florida Wine Fest, and we're lucky to be joined by these great, amazing chefs. So we want to welcome everyone. But before we get to all the dishes, Sam, I want to start off and start talking to you a little bit. Tell me about Banquet on the Block. What is it?
And so Banquet on the Block is right in front of Madison's and Salute, mm-hmm. and they close off the whole street with a long, long table, 200 seats, 5 courses, 5 chefs, 5 restaurants. It's so much fun.
Oh, it's amazing. Look at this. That's the scene of this. Is almost like picturesque. You almost don't believe it's real mm-hmm. until you get there. And we've had a couple instances where we have accidentally ended up there.
We did get there, as a
yes,
matter of fact.
Did.
We actually were on our way somewhere else,
yes.
and we stopped.
Yes.
We were having Stephanie's bachelor party.
Yes.
We were walking down the street, and we stumbled upon it.
And we saw this long table, and hey, crashed it. Why not sit down?
But you should have a reservation.
This yes. might not yes. have worked this out. This year, we'll have a reservation.
Well, you know, this is actually for an organization, the organization that's putting on, it's the Wine Fest. And, you know, they actually help to support a lot of things. Tell me how much money they've raised. You told me that it was a lot.
Over $8.2 million for children's right. charities.
Yeah. So that's
for amazing. Children's charities.
Children's charities.
So it's not just to eat, it's for a great cause. So, but the food is also amazing. So let's go to the end and start with the chef. Tell us about your restaurant, who you are, and the dish you made.
Yes, hello. I'm Laszlo Bevardi from Salute Restaurant in downtown Sarasota, right where the block party is going to be. And we are preparing pan-seared halibut, which is flown in fresh from Alaska. And I took a Mediterranean twist on it this time. We're going to have a little bit of fire-roasted cherry tomatoes. And the shrimp scampi sauce with that. Ooh. And all this is going to be served over lemon and asparagus risotto. Nice and creamy with a little bit of Parmesan cheese.
Sounds Ooh. Amazing.
All right, well, Linda and Cliff, you have samples of that, so you can
oh,
dig in. And
right.
this is one of the main courses, since there will be several courses as part
oh,
of the event.
Oh, this will be on the night of the banquet.
Yes, Ooh. Taste it and tell us, is it good?
Mmm.
They got a thumbs up.
Got it.
We won't hear from them again. They're now busy.
All right, so Sam, you're from Tsunami, but you also have a dish that you're going to be
That's
displaying.
Right. We're a third course. Our protein is shrimp, so we are going to do the little Asian flair. We've got brown sushi rice, avocado, cucumber, and then this is steamed shrimp, Japanese seasonings, and finished with spicy mayo.
Ooh.
Ooh, I like the look of
well,
that.
I feel like since try. Linda already had some, I should try to steal this from her.
Right, yeah, pull it back, Boba. And I hate to topple your tower, Sam, but I'm going to.
Go for it, Stephanie.
Why would you ruin it?
Because I want to try it.
Linda, I should have gave it to you.
Yeah, you should have. Well, doesn't it break your heart when people mess up your creations like that and eat them?
I love to see people enjoy it.
That's what I thought he'd say. That's yeah. why I did it.
All
I
right.
thought we're safe.
So,
are you going to put that in your mouth and talk?
Yes, I'm counting.
Yeah, I guess so. Now, see, now she can't talk.
I'm Alex from Madison's 41. I'm the chef there. If we're doing the beef course, mm-hmm. and which is going to be fennel pollen whipped carrots.
Ooh.
We did some Nyman Ranch petite filet, and then there'll be a ramp onion pesto, and then a ramp onion and tomato confit.
We got one of these too.
Now, ramp onions aren't quite in season yet. They got a really short season. I think between like April and early June. So they're a really high commodity during that time, and we love to have that on a dish for you guys.
All right, I need to ask
it looks
what,
amazing.
A ramp onion?
Ramp onion.
What's
ramp
that
onion,
mean?
It's also called a wild leek, but they're a cross between like a garlic and onion. And they got kind of that distinct
oh, wow.
flavor to them, but they're really pungent. They got a really short season, and chefs really try to fight over them when the time comes. So.
And they're almost caramelized
yeah,
in this.
Almost caramelized. Wow. That's right.
That's amazing.
It is.
I would have never known that was a ramp onion. So I'm glad you pointed it out.
Well, I'm glad to be able to serve that for you guys. So
that's great. Looks
and
wonderful.
And of course, we can't forget there's desserts.
There's always dessert. We're going to pass around the back here because I want to talk to you about this wonderful dish. Introduce yourself and tell us what you brought.
I'm Mara Christiani, and I'm from Laurel Oak Country Club. And I wanted to do creme brulee, which is a very traditional dessert, but not a flavor that you would normally associate with it. So
oh.
this is a licorice root and a 10-year aged balsamic vinegar.
All right.
Okay.
Now, don't let the name scare you. Go ahead and taste it.
All right. I'm a little scared of the licorice part, I'll admit.
It's excellent.
It's not what you would think. Isn't that good? And then on top, you have little blackberry caviar. So I juiced blackberries. And I turned them into caviar.
Oh, really?
Wait, these are blackberries that you took apart.
They were big ones?
I juiced the caviar. Oh, my gosh. I mean, the blackberries, and I turned them into a little caviar.
Well, that's magic.
So, molecular gastronomy here.
So unusual and so creative.
Thank you.
And what made you think of that?
Well, you know, we're always playing with different things, and we had gotten in sassafras and birch and cedar root. And my executive sous chef, he's a genius, is Michael Freeman. And he said, Maura, I've got these tinctures. You want to play around with them? And at first I was going to do anise. And I said, you know what? Give me those tinctures. And I tried sassafras. It had a bitter finish. And so I settled on the licorice. It's subtle, but it's there.
Mm. Wow.
I thought it would be an interesting choice.
A lot of creativity on this table.
Absolutely.
And of course, again, it's for a good cause. So if you want to get tickets and information, Banquet on the Block is Friday, April 7th at 6:30 on Lemon Avenue. For tickets, go to floridawinefest.org. Next, a game of, is it from Florida? True or false? We'll let you know. We'll be right back.